National Hockey League has returned to Winnipeg, Manitoba, and the Pittsburgh Penguins are back here for the first time since 1996. It's the Pens, it's the Jets, and it's on Root Sports here tonight. Now, if you're going to come to Winnipeg, you need to walk through the corner of Portage and Main. It's the center of the banking industry here in Winnipeg, and it's unofficially the coldest and windiest street corner in all of Canada. Unfortunately, I couldn't get a reason why. No one seems to have the true answer. However, my colleague Paul Stagerwald actually did a story on it a few years back. Maybe you got an answer.
Well, it probably has something to do with how flat it is here. And that wind picks up a lot of steam as it comes across the prairies, Bob. And let me tell you, it was really blowing when we came in yesterday and all day today, about 50 miles an hour, it seemed. You saw those flags fluttering in the cold winds.
Well, and then you take a look at a guy that he doesn't weigh a lot. He might have been almost bowled over in that wind, Marc-Andre Fleury. Svelte, 3-1 on the season, got his first loss against the Buffalo Sabres on the weekend. The Penguins looking to bounce back behind Marc-Andre Fleury. Dan Bylsma, drafted by the Winnipeg Jets, if you can believe it or not, back in 1989. And look out. Board is Kyle Wellwood, the old Leaf.
Open my mic.
The 3-on-1, a blown tire by McCulloch. And Kyle Wellwood is on the board.
Well, that's a good way to start if you're trying to get back on track and get your first win. How about doing it on your first shift?
Amazing. Oh, what a start for the Winnipeg Jets, who gave up a quick goal in their last hockey game. A tic-tac-toe play, Antropov to Vermistrov, over to Kyle Wellwood, and Wellwood was able to somehow corral that puck and get it under the left pad of Marc-Andre Fleury. 1-0 Jets, and they got a 2-on-1 again.
And a chance this time, coming down the right side, defenseman Ron Hainsey with an opportunity, and Marc-Andre Fleury stopped him. Now Vermistrov in the corner. And Vermistrov works it in behind. Paul Martin moves it out to Aaron Ashton. Taken now by Matt Cook down the wing. Cook shoots it high and wide off the glass. And McCulloch can't keep it in. It'll go all the way back into the Penguins zone. Some technical difficulties here at the start. And we'll apologize for that, but we're enjoying the atmosphere here in this building as these fans are just loving the fact that they've got Winnipeg Jets hockey again here. And, of course, they would love to have seen Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin, but at this point, they're just happy to have their own team, the Jets, playing in front of them here in this building. There's a chance for Buffalo, and he rips it high and wide off the glass to the near side. Toby Enstrom works it back around to the right side. Thorburn tried to move it back to the point. Kunitz got in the way of that. Now Buffalo with it. They're announcing the goal scorer right now. Jordan Staal and Chris Letang trying to get control. Derek Engelin tried to move it out. Now Letang takes over, and he'll work it up off the glass. Didn't get it out. Turnover by the Penguins results in another chance for Gibbs Slater, who ripped one wide of the goal. Now Bufflin all over the ice, as usual, in the offensive zone, is forced back to center. Another back into his own zone.
And that's Hainsey on the goal there. Looked like Kyle Wellwood to me. If you look at the Toyota lines for the Penguins here. On the backside, you got Martin and McCulloch, who started this hockey game. McCulloch blew the tire. Chris Letang is playing with Derek Englund, who got a skate across his face. Very fortunate. He sees no stitches at all, so. Not a good start for Pittsburgh at all, minus Tyler Kennedy.
Now Ben Lovejoy banks it ahead to center. Taken there by Steve Sullivan. Working against Bogosian. Following on to take the puck is Mark Stewart. And now over to Zach Bogosian. To Stewart. And the Jets are definitely feeling a lot better right now. They were a team that was lacking some confidence and belief. But they wanted to simplify their game under Claude Newell here tonight. And to be able to get that goal in the first shift will give them a much more relaxed feeling about the rest of this hockey game, and give them a positive feeling about what they might be able to accomplish here tonight after going 0-3 in their first three games of the year.
And I want to see what the Penguins can accomplish down by one early in this hockey game against really a hostile crowd here. And they obviously haven't kept the crowd out of this one, Stegi. They were pumped up for the start of this. They wanted to see Crosby and Malkin, of course. And they'd rather see their team win.
Joe Vitale drops it back to Paul Martin. Now to Zabinek McCulloch. Penguins 3-1-2, 2-0-1 on the road so far this year. And they'll play this road game and then a back-to-back situation as they play the Minnesota Wild tomorrow night. Now it's Wellwood, the former Maple Leaf, trying to get it out. He's the goal scorer. And now Vermistrov takes it on the left wing, and Vermistrov will dump it into the Penguins zone to the corner. Wellwood in after, bumped off the puck by Adams, and now Martin tries to move it up, but it comes right to Adams in front of his own net, to McCulloch, and he is bumped in the neutral zone after dumping the puck into the Winnipeg zone. Matt Cook in after it. Puck was at his feet, didn't see it. And Bogosian, taking third overall in 08, moves it out to Vermistrov. He's a first-round pick from last year. Vermistrov holds it and finds Mark Stewart. Stewart with a wrist shot. And it was blocked by Aaron Asham. And out of the reach of Derek Engelin, it's taken now by Brett McClain, who was a really good goal scorer in junior hockey, a second-round pick of the Coyotes. They gave up on him, but the Jets got him on waivers. And he's a guy who scored a ton of goals alongside of John Tavares when he played junior hockey.
And look at this bad communication by the Penguins.
Bufflin's drive is wide of the goal. And every time he shoots the puck, it's a scary moment for anybody who's in front of that shot. And then remember that amazing block that Max Talbot made last year at the end of a game against Dustin Bufflin and the Atlanta Thrashers at the Mellon Arena. And that was last year at the Consol Energy Center. And now the puck handled by Chris Letang, and they'll bring it back up into the Winnipeg zone.
Look at the forwards. Richard Park, you mentioned it in the open, the only player that played here in Winnipeg on the Penguins roster. Jordan Staal, Kunitz, and Dupuis. The test to centering that third line with Matt Cook and Winnipeg, almost Winnipeg native Aaron Asham, the Vitali unit, the fourth line rounding out things for the Penguins. Joe Vitali leads all Penguin centermen in faceoff percentage.
58.1%. Pretty amazing. He's had some good faceoff numbers so far this year. Andre Pavlik is in goal. He has yet to face a shot from the Penguins.
Penguins are sleeping right now, Staggy's already interrupted, but they got to wake up. There was a bad start. Bad communication there in the last shift with Fleury in the defenseman. They got to get going here.
Slater moves it to the right side of Thorburn. Challenged by Niskanen. He runs it right into the board. Over to play it is Tanner Glass. Bufflin also. He poked it down the wall, but taken by Lovejoy. Out to Kunitz. Good pressure on him from Stewart. And Dupuis tries to knock it in deep, and he can't do so. And offside is called as the Penguins enter the Winnipeg zone. Andre Pavlik, 0-7 in his career against the Penguins, with a 4.68 goals against average. You see his career numbers. This guy has never beaten Pittsburgh.
No, but he's had a couple of hat tricks against them. One by Malkin and one by Crosby, and he's happy not to see them here tonight. Tyler Kennedy, we all know how much Tyler Kennedy shoots the puck too, so the Penguins are going to have to find some production, at least shot production, from somebody else other than just James Neal in this hockey game. Yet to register one on Pavlik, who had a tough start in Atlanta last year, if you can remember.
Andrew Ladd dumped the puck in. Brian Little centering this line with Blake Wheeler. He's got the puck right now on the right wing, and Andrew Ladd on the left. It's a pretty good line. Bogosian risks the puck to the corner, and out to the point now to Stewart. This shot off a stick. Paul Martin pressured by Blake Wheeler. Wheeler tries to pick his pocket. Really good hard work that time by Blake Wheeler. One possession of the puck, and he centered it off the skate of Richard Park. Ladd cycles the puck in behind for Little. Now to Wheeler. Back for Little. Ladd tries to get open in the high slot. James Neal has his eye on him. Now it's Bogosian with a shot, and Neal got out to block that. Checks his stick to make sure it's not broken as the puck sails up into the netting behind Marc-Andre Fleury.
There he is. Coach of the year, the old Winnipeg Jet draft pick. And that surprised me. I did not realize that Dan Bylsma was drafted by the Winnipeg Jets back in 1989. You talked about it this morning, Staggy. He was on the way to church when he got the news of that. And there's Claude Noel, the new coach, behind the bench here in Winnipeg.
Once worked with Ray Shiro in Milwaukee. Ray Shiro hired him to coach the Milwaukee Admirals. And Ray was the GM of that team from the Nashville Predators organization. And they won a championship together in the American League in 04. Claude Noel, who was an interim coach, head coach for the Columbus Blue Jackets a couple of years ago after Ken Hitchcock was fired. Last year he coached the Manitoba Moose right here in this building. Now it's Letang taking it in front of his own net. Antropov hit on the forecheck. Engelin moves it out on right wing off the stick of Adams and up into the Winnipeg zone. Pavlik sends it back up the near wall. Vermistrov is there. It's taken instead by Slater, who shuffled it, or Oduya shuffled it in behind. And now out to Vermistrov to Antropov. Wellwood will take the right wing pass. Drop pass for Vermistrov. And Fritz! Oh, Antropov kicked at that puck and directed it wide of the goal. Now Bogosian with it. Antropov has had good numbers against the Penguins in his career, a point a game average. Now it's Bermistrov with it, strong on the puck. The Jets have 9 first round picks in their lineup tonight. Pretty high picks. Centering pass. McLean. Stapleton. Back for Brett McLean. Cook over, but they move it to the point. And it goes and slap shot. Saved by Fleury. The rebound. Still loose. Stapleton can't find it. And the Penguins finally get possession. And McLean was in there banging away as well. And the fans are loving it right now. This is a very tight building. Only 15,000. It was built for the American League team here, the Moose. So it's a very intimate building, and the fans are very loud and right on top of the ice here.
And if Chris Letang had not made a defensive play in front of his own zone, it would be 2-0 on Stapleton. He had a wide-open cage.
Here's Niskanen. Looks for Lovejoy. Lovejoy posted to the corner. Letestu behind the net for Aaron Asham. Bumped by Thorburn. Asham centers. Cleared away and taken by Tanner Glass. Now it's Niskanen with it. Thorburn will slap it up into the Penguin zone.
Good quick play by Fleury right there. Letang fell down in that shift. And you saw McCulloch fall down in the first goal. Crazy. I thought the ice was supposed to be good.
It looked really good in the warm-up. I think it is good here. It's a very cold building. But a lot of warmth from the fans right now. Still no shots for the Penguins in this game. 4 for the Jets. And Dan Bylsma did not have a happy look on his face a moment ago when we showed him. He looks a little upset. Why not? And the Penguins playing without the services of a lot of players tonight. Those are AGH scratches, Malkin, Kennedy, and Orpik. Tyler Kennedy suffering from concussion-like symptoms. He alerted the training staff for that last night. Buffalo with a shot on a blocker save made by Marc-Andre Fleury.
That was the old give-and-goal lad in Buffalo working it there.
Now Toby Enstrom can't hold it in, and he'll have to go back and get it.
Part of the problem I saw there was Aaron Asham was on his wrong wing. He was playing left wing. He had to change. He was on the ice playing the left side. He was used to playing a little bit of left, but he got a little confused on that give and go by Ladd and Buffalo.
Jordan Staal will dump the puck to the corner. Enstrom rips it up the board. Staal tried to move it along and ends up coming to James Neal because of it. He was in good defensive position in the offensive zone. He gets himself back and really creates opportunities for the Penguins to restart on offense in the offensive zone. Now it's Buffalo with it. Martin trying to hold it. Can't hold the line, but they're Staal in perfect position to cover up for his defenseman, Paul Martin. Staal battling to try to maintain possession. Pulled the legs out from under Andrew Ladd. The fans want a penalty. No penalty call. Paul Martin runs it up the wall.
The Penguins were really late in their change here. Richard Park came out way late.
Shot by Oduya. No rebound this time as Wellwood came swooping right in front of the Penguins' goal. The Penguins trying to get untracked here in Winnipeg. Unfamiliar surroundings, and they're down 1-0. Winnipeg 1 and Pittsburgh 0. The Winnipeg Jets made Bobby Hall a Jet. He was the original Jet back in 72 when they entered the WHA, and then Dale Hawerchuk came along as a first pick overall in 81. What a great player he was. And he's now the captain, was the captain. He's the coach of the Barry Colts. And there is Teemu Selanne. He scored 76 goals in his rookie season in 92-93 with the Jets. And they do have a great tradition here, and they're so happy to have NHL hockey back. Bobby Hull and Dale Hawerchuk are actually in town today, signing autographs over at the corner of Portage and Main. Dan Potash showed you a moment ago. Hawerchuk is supposed to be in the building tonight for the game.
Yeah, he is. Bobby Hull, the Golden Jet. And Dale Hawerchuk, nicknamed Ducky. I play with him in Buffalo for a cup of coffees.
Here's Richard Park. Finally, Penguins trying to get it going. Have no shots yet. 7 for the Jets here. Almost halfway through the first period. Richard Park with it. And he's held up. Draws a penalty from Blake Wheeler.
Free hand. You can't twist a man with a free hand, Blake. Why are you arguing? It's the new National Hockey League. It's a simple call, and it was the right call. Richard Park moving his feet. Wheeler, and there's the hand around him. I mean, you just can't give the opportunity to allow the ref to make that call.
So the Penguins get the chance to put their power play to work. Brought to you by UPMC Sports Medicine. The Penguins won for their last 18 on the power play. It was hot to start the year, but the absence of Evgeny Malkin has hurt them in that area. With Malkin, the Penguins are 5 for 13 on the power play. Without him, they're 1 for 14. So guys like Stevie Sullivan, Chris Letang, Mark Letestu, Jordan Staal, you hope for them to pick up the slack here on the power play for the Penguins and get them right back into this game. A goal here and all that stuff that happened at the beginning doesn't mean a whole lot. Winnipeg up 1-0. And they're able to clear.
Well, that's an appreciable difference there in terms of power plays when you don't have your big guns out there like Crosby and Malkin. And you don't have Tyler Kennedy either in this situation, so don't look for him as a go-to guy. But look at the speed Neal's carrying through the neutral zone.
Well, Duja and Enstrom are back defensively. Sullivan, so good at bringing that puck up on the power play. Gets it all the way in deep. Now can the Penguins maintain possession? Dupuis can't get over. He's beaten to the puck by Bromistrov. And he was able to shoot it down the ice. Now he's looking at Dupuis and...
He was, because he got a little whack. You know what? If I'm Pascal Dupuis, I go by him again. I give him another whack and say, how do you like that? I mean, this is hockey here. Bromistrov's a young kid. You get into his kitchen. If that bothers him, you hit him again and again. And the Penguins got to get a little bit mean here in this hockey game and find it.
Take a look at how the Penguins' goals have been distributed throughout their situational play. And you look at even strength, 8 scored, 14 against. The power play has scored 6 goals. No shorthanded goals allowed yet this year. They've scored a couple and have allowed only 1 power play goal. Penalty killing has been spectacular. And right now they're on this power play and hoping to tie this game up with 46 seconds left on the penalty to Blake Wheeler.
The thing about the even strength goals is they don't have any even strength goals from their defensemen, the Penguins, this year. They got 2 power play goals, one by Niskanen and one by Letang.
Neal has trouble holding the puck, and he's going to have to go back along with Paul Martin and regroup here. And Paul Martin... right back to James Neal. He'll wrist it around to the right wing board, taken there by Jordan Staal. Off his stick and cleared. Ron Hainsey got it down the ice. You can tell the Jets, to a man, they're doing a lot of soul searching over the last couple of days. They wanted to make sure they came out and put on a good show for their fans in their second home game here tonight. And they've done so far. 9 seconds to go on this penalty. Still no shots for the Penguins on the power play. Martin Scott registered. Staal with a rebound try. And that's was stopped in front, and down the ice it goes, and the Jets did a good job to kill the penalty, and the Penguins did not register a shot until the last ticks on the clock.
Well, they had too many men on the ice again, the Penguins. They're discombobulated. What do you want me to say? They don't even have a shot on net. There's 8:11 left. It's a poor start by Pittsburgh.
Take a look at our barrel leaders.
Go. 7 games played. That's a lot of games for the Pittsburgh Penguins, who have 13 games in 24 days to start the season this year in Colorado and Tampa following there.
The Penguins have 16 sets of back-to-backs this year. This is the second one of the year so far. We're playing Minnesota tomorrow night.
A lot of travel for Pittsburgh. And covering a lot of air miles here. A little weary to start this hockey game. Luckily not charged with too many men on the ice on that last occasion. Vitaly jumped on, ill-advised.
One thing you take good out of all this is that the Jets, their dominant play here early, still only have a 1-0 lead. The Penguins very much in this game and can get the ship straightened out pretty easily. And look at the games coming up, as Bob said. 3 road trips, 5 games in Canada. Today was the first time that it really felt like we were in Canada. And by the time we come back here on December 23rd, it's probably going to have really look like the Great White North. Here's Bufflin with it. Big slap shot off a stick wide. Ladd was in front trying to redirect that shot. And the guys who stand in front of the net when Bufflin's shooting are putting their lives at risk. Last year, Brian Little was hit twice by a Bufflin shot in front of the net. Chipped the foot. Hurt his elbow. He's got the puck right now, busting in, backhands one to the corner, and it's been great to Matt Cook, and a good chance for the Penguins to rush back. Cook and Adams and Vitaly. Pass out of the reach of Adams, but Vitaly right there trying to sneak one in. Cleared away by Little, and it goes up into the netting, and a couple of Penguins are down in the corner. Big collision down there. Cook, Vitaly, Ladd, and one of the Jets all involved in that collision.
Well, Joe Vitaly had a great opportunity on a rebound off the pads of Pavlik. He's just sitting at his feet, and he really had to elevate it. Unfortunately, he went right into the netting. The puck comes to the front of the net. It was actually Matt Cook who had the second opportunity as Vitaly shuffled it into the feet of Pavlik. Pavlik fainted last year in the opener for the Atlanta Thrashers. Scary situation down in Atlanta.
Will slap pass ahead to Neal. Stick handle, shoots it. He hit the goalpost.
And that puck is way up in the crowd behind the bench of the Winnipeg Jets. That's how hard James Neal shot that puck. This is a set faceoff by the Penguins. And you watch as they win that faceoff back, they're able to spring Neal right up the middle of the ice. And everybody spreads. It's like the parting of the Red Sea.
Oh, he almost picked that corner. Face off to the right of Andre Pavlik. He's faced only two Penguin shots, 7:17 to go in the first period. The Jets scoring 8 seconds in. Wellwood from Antropov and Burmistrov.
Funny thing, it's still funny seeing the Winnipeg Jets.
It is. It's hard. You know, these names all in my head are just ringing Atlanta Thrashers. So keep wanting to call them Thrashers. Here's Richard Park back to the net. Whacking at it is Neal. Pavlik stood his ground. Neal steps out again. Poked away by Johnny Oduya out of the corner. Now Sullivan can't play it. And Ron Heinze finds Kyle Wellwood. He gives some ground and snaps it along to Johnny Oduya. Leaves it out to Nick Antropov. And he just dumps it to open space. Penguins are changing. Pascal Dupuis, Jordan Staal, and Chris Kunitz on the ice. And Dupuis, of course, played for this franchise. He played 62 games with Atlanta before being traded to the Penguins in 08. Here's Staal with it. Staal to Engelin. Back deep he goes with it to the far corner and Letang in deep. Finds Jordan Staal. Staal tries to center off the side of the cage and handled by Tanner Glass. He lifts it out to center. Engelin back for Kunitz. Glass checks him.
Here we go, a scrap.
Engelin and Thorburn.
Yeah, Thorburn, the ex-Penguin. Oh, there's a good right by Engelin, who's cut up by a skate yesterday or Saturday in Buffalo.
First scrap of the year for Derek Engelin. A couple of right hands on Thorburn, hitting him pretty good. Thorburn trying to keep close. And there's another shot.
Thorburn's in a little bit of trouble right now. Engelin's saying, no, don't break us up right now. He wants to finish this off. You gotta be careful at the end of a tired fight like this for one player going down hard.
Thorburn tried a right hand there. He got one last shot in and he is out of gas. And Derek Engelin says, good job. And they are broken up.
And look at his face, Deggy. That's a skate went across Engelin's left cheek. And it's been opened up right now by this scrap. He has no stitches in that, just a couple of good marks by the skate blade.
Wow.
One nothing Winnipeg as we wind our way through the first period here in Manitoba. And Aaron Asham is from Portage La Prairie, Manitoba, which is about 45 minutes outside of Winnipeg. So yes, once upon a time, he was a much smaller hockey player. And he was a fan of the original Winnipeg Jets. He's in the far left corner of that picture. We'll explain how not only is he connected, but some of the current and former Winnipeg Jets are also very happy to see hockey back here in Winnipeg. He almost looks the same, doesn't he, guys?
Yeah, that's a heck of a mullet he's got going there. But for Aaron Asham, he still looks tough, doesn't he? He looks tough as a youngster.
Bought 60 tickets for this game tonight.
Oh, boy, that's costly.
Paul Martin with it now. The Penguins down 1-0. And the old Atlanta Thrashers scored the first goal in the last six games against the Penguins. So they picked up where they left off here as the Winnipeg Jets scoring first. And you can't score much faster than they did 8 seconds into the game.
Nope, but the Penguins have got the last three shots. They've got some good forechecking. The line of Dupuis and Staal go out there. They get a couple of bangs in. That's what you have to have. You look to your energy guys to really turn the tide, get the momentum in your side.
Oh, boy, what a faceoff by Antropov.
Oduya shot. Looks through a screen wide of the goal. Wellwood works into the corner. Antropov can't stop it. Now taken on the near side by Asham. He moves it out into the middle to Mark Letestu. Back to play it is Ron Heinze. Up the wall now for Wellwood. Antropov got a stick on it, but Aaron Asham there. Letang able to keep it in. A shot hits Asham. Burmistrov's got it now. Both teams making some changes here as Johnny Oduya takes it. And the former Devil up ahead to Antropov, who steers it into the Penguin zone. Fleury stopped it. Boy, Martin had to be quick to get to that puck before Wheeler did. When Wheeler took it away, Martin gets it right back. Sullivan tries to get it out. Bogosian pinching down the wall. Blake Wheeler there too. Big strong winger is able to pry it free. And then Fleury moves it along for Chris Letang. He looks it out now for Sullivan. And an offside call on the play. The Penguins will stay on the road. And they'll have the Minnesota Wild tomorrow night. We'll have the game for you at 7 p.m. here on Root Sports. Penguins and Wild tomorrow.
Penguins kind of with a set play, lofting that puck high in the air as they just took off down the ice. Another kind of miscommunication by Marc-Andre Fleury in defense behind the net. Really, Paul Martin had to be very sharp, very, very sharp and quick to get to that.
I got to ask you, I think Fleury has had some problems in that area already this year, and kind of throughout the last couple of years, there have been times where he's had issues with handling the puck behind the net, Bob. And there's one added element here too, and that might be the crowd here tonight. It might be hard to hear some of those signals that the players exchange when the puck comes behind the net.
Yeah, he's got to, so then you have to be more visual, don't you? You can't just listen to sounds. You have to actually have your eyes on the oncoming player.
Stahl, rebound, backhand shot by Kunitz, misses the cage. Great chance for Stahl. Now here's Niskanen and Kunitz, especially Kunitz, and that was wide open and they missed it. Here's Lovejoy with it. Sends it up the boards. Over the plate is Dupuis. And gets hung up on the near side of another offside play. And we'll drop it in the neutral zone.
Well, tough to tell once again here, this energy unit with Kunitz, Dupuis, and Stahl. The first shot by Stahl. Kunitz may have just grazed the post on a backhand. Always tougher on that backhand.
Yeah, he did.
He had a stick on him as well. You saw the stick of 19 Slater right there. Just grazing that post. Slater getting his first ever hockey goal, National Hockey League goal against the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Got two already this season for the Jets.
McIntyre's out, look out.
Big truck comes down the wall, but overskates the puck, and back they come. Mark Scheifele is in the lineup tonight. Rookie, only 18 years old, taking seventh overall in the recent draft. He was expected to go around 21st, and the Jets, like a lot of other scouts, were very impressed with the way he came on late in the season, and he is on the ice right now, number 55. Mark Scheifele, a very smart player. Ben Lovejoy took him hard into the near boards, though. He fell down. Now here's McLean with it. He's able to push it to the net off a stick and right to Marc-Andre Fleury, and he holds on to it.
Well, Scheifele, he was you talk about smarts. He played for Dale Hawerchuk, the ex-Jet, in Barrie last year for the Barrie Colts. 6'3". And I was looking at his stick today with the big toe curve. Then I was looking at Tobias Enstrom's stick. And if Tobias Enstrom is 5'10", well, they're stretching it. But Tobias Enstrom's stick is 3 inches longer than the 6'3", Scheifele.
And Toby Enstrom is just notorious for having that long stick. We'll show you that when we get a chance. Here's Matt Cook with it. Drops it off. Assen's drive. Stick save made by Pavlik. Hainsey fired it off the boards. Matt Cook right there trying to work it deep. Mark Letestu on the ice too. Cook's shot blocked. Comes free. Shot by Letang. Save made by Pavlik. And he's able to corral the rebound. Letang jumping in with a good chance. And the Penguins coming on now. Remember when the shots were 7-0 and 7-1? Now they're 8-6.
Yeah, the best thing the Penguins did, and Marc-Andre Fleury has not allowed that second goal by the Jets. And the momentum has shifted in Pittsburgh's way. Chris Letang, the defenseman, looking for the first even-strength goal from the blue line this year.
Letang with it. Matt Cook for Letestu. Oduya takes him into the wall. Asham follows on. Dimitrov gets to the puck. Now Letang takes it. Letestu looks for Asham off a stick and up into the seats on the near side. Take a look at this day in Penguins history, October 17th, 1991, and look who scored a hat trick. Oh.
They were all beauties, end to end, top shelf.
Did you have any other hat tricks in your career, Bob?
Oh, boy, you was so many. I can't remember, Steggy. I'd have to look that one up.
Here's Niskanen shooting and a save by Pavlik. Now taken by Andrew Ladd. Blake Wheeler trying to get a step on Martin. Shoots it. Martin got a stick in there and it deflected up off the glass. Ladd works it to the corner. And big Blake Wheeler takes it there. Wheeler left it on the wall. Little with a shot. Hit something on the way in and went wide on the short side on Fleury. And now Sullivan trying to get it up ahead to Neal. Little Toby Enstrom kept it in. And it comes to the Jets at center ice. Ladd, Bufflin. Bufflin trying to barge in. Shoots it. Save made. Rebound. He overskated it. Paul Martin gets to the puck. Bufflin went down like a ton of bricks behind the net. You felt the earth move. 265 pounds went down hard. Here comes Richard Park.
Look at him back check. That's pretty impressive.
Lovejoy works it down low. Kunitz is there, turns the corner, shoots it. Neal there, and he can't get it to the goal. Boy, Kunitz looked like he had a chance to wrap that puck around on the backhand into the net, but it didn't go that way. Now Lovejoy, stall off the glass. And Lovejoy again trying to get it going north, but Demistra hustles in against Letang. Takes the puck away from him. Great play. Shot by Glass. He scores. Banner Glass on a great play. Burmistrov finishes it off to give the Jets a 2-0 lead.
Now the Russian Burmistrov turns 20 in a couple of days, but the 19-year-old strips the puck with a lot of passion and a lot of will and desire against Chris Letang, one of the best in the business. Take a look at Burmistrov, moving the feet, being aggressive, staying with it, stripping the puck, leaves Slater in front for the screen. Marc-Andre Fleury cannot get out on top of that blue paint to cut down the angle and setting the platter right there. The screen, the blast, 2-0.
That was a passionate shift by the youngster Burmistrov. Talk about setting the table there. You just lay that into the wheelhouse.
Letang had to skate a long way with great speed to close in on Burmistrov. He got to the puck and it ended up in his feet and he couldn't find it. He took the man, but then couldn't find the puck. Burmistrov did, and he found Glass, and it's 2-0 Winnipeg. Tanner Glass for the corner, and it is loud in this building. Slater with it. Bogosian with it. Shoots it. Now Adams tries to get control. After losing their opener in this building to Montreal 5-1, they then lost 4-3 at Chicago and 4-1 at Phoenix. And that was the game that really stuck in the craw of their coach Claude Noel, the loss in Phoenix.
Yeah, it provoked him to say, I believe we're better than that, but we haven't proved it to ourselves yet. Not sure what we're waiting for.
Well, what they're waiting for is to get back home. One of these loud fans. And they are having fun right now. They're chanting Fleury, Fleury, as the Jets, after seeing the Penguins gain some momentum, took it away with that goal by Tanner Glass. We're down to 32 seconds to go in the period. Letestu works it behind the net. Asham collides with Scheifele. And Oduya has control. There's a stick on the ice. It was Cook's stick. He goes to the bench. And James Neal steps into the attacking zone with only 15 seconds to go in the period.
Remember the save that Pavlik made on Kunitz there. It looked like Kunitz had a chance to wrap that around on his backhand. Puck comes the other way, 2-0.
Ben Lovejoy back to the puck, 2 seconds to go. And the fans on their feet, making a lot of noise for the Winnipeg Jets, who lead it 2-0. Take a look at our Fort Pitt Capital by the numbers first period recap.
5-4 in terms of chances. Jets won a couple more faceoffs, didn't have a power play. The Penguins had that one opportunity when Park got held.
But this opening shift and 8 seconds in was all it took to propel the Jets into the lead.
Dan Potash will visit with Chris Kunitz. We'll have a feature on the return of the Jets to Winnipeg, Manitoba. And also highlights and analysis coming up. It's Winnipeg 2 and Pittsburgh nothing. 2-0 Jets. First game for the Penguins here since February 16th, 1996. Penguins won a game 1-0. Jaromir Jagr from Sergei Zubov. Look at Jagr's 46th of the year. That was in February of that year. And if you look at who was in the lineup for the Penguins, you'll notice down on the left of your screen, on the right, Richard Park, number 76. So he's the only guy who's in the lineup tonight for the Penguins that was here that night when the Penguins played their last game in the first era of Winnipeg Jets hockey here in Winnipeg. Richard Park comes back at the age of 35, and tonight playing in between James Neal and Steve Sullivan, where Evgeny Malkin had been playing. So that's the one thing that he brings to this team, is that versatility. You can play him on a fourth line. You can jump him up, and he can give you some offense on that top line, which he's doing here tonight in the absence of Evgeny Malkin. Malkin, Crosby, Orpik, none of them made the trip to Winnipeg. Chance for the Penguins right off the hop. They almost get 1 second into the period, as Letestu had a chance at the side of the post. And now Burmistrov takes it in his own zone. He's it out to big Nick Antropov playing in the middle tonight. He had been playing on the wing with Burmistrov at center, but they switched it up, put Antropov in the middle with Burmistrov on the wing. This is Wellwood. He shoots it, and a stick save made by Fleury, and the rebound to Aaron Ashton. Out to Matt Cook. And Cook in after it now against Johnny Oduya. Whacks at him, runs him into the boards. Letestu takes the puck. Now Cook banks it off the cage. And it's taken by Burmistrov, who gives ground here. Cook will pressure him. And some help from Ron Hainsey, but Cook trying to pick the pocket of Ron Hainsey. Now it's Sullivan with a penalty coming up. It's going to be against the Jets. So good hard work on the forecheck by the Penguins. Is able to draw the penalty, and the Penguins will put their power play to work here early in the second period.
Well, I think Burmistrov got a little bit too comfortable in his shoes, or in his skates, if you will. And he kept that puck in his defensive zone way too long. Hainsey had to play the puck after the fact. Some good aggressive forechecking by Cook and company, and Hainsey's in the box. The Winnipeg Jets goal 8 seconds into that first period ties a Winnipeg Jet record set by Doug Smale, the old Jet, and is actually a new Atlanta Thrashers, if you go that direction, a new Thrashers record for the quickest goal to open a game.
Our UPMC Sports Medicine power play. Second chance for the Penguins. Taken by Paul Martin, and he'll leave it now for Sullivan. And Sullivan likes to carry that puck on the power play. He just surveys the situation, immediately finds the right outlet to gain good entries into the offensive zone. He's so smooth at it. He makes it look so easy when we know that it isn't. Here's Neal's shot, save, rebound. Sullivan poked away just as he was ready to tee it up. Now Neal with another drive and a pad save made by Pavlik. And the Jets go the other way, and it's Andrew Ladd back shorthanded against Martin. A little curl and drag move, and the shot off a stick up into the netting in the corner. Take a look at our UPMC Sports Medicine injury update. We're talking about the guys who did not make the trip. And then you can add Tyler Kennedy to that.
Here he is. Right there on the bottom of the graphic, Tyler Kennedy. He just informed the coaches last night that he was suffering from those post-concussion syndromes.
And we might as well, while we have the opportunity, Bob, say hello to those four guys who are back watching the game right now in Pittsburgh. Sid, Gino, Dustin Jeffrey, and Brooks Orpik. Hi, guys. Let's get you back in the lineup soon.
Yeah, certainly missed them. Penguins losing their last two. Looking to get off the schneid here.
Matt Cook with it. Cleared, and Letang will have to chase it down to neutral ice. Oh, with a nice one-touch pass to Mark Letestu. And Letestu wanted to set it up from the half boards, but is pressured. We've got 32 seconds to go on the penalty to Hainsey. Look out. Here's Letang with it now. Over to Staal. Staal turns and looks at the net, finds Letang. A little slap pass. Niskanen the shot. Two. Hooked there for the rebound. Tries to turn the corner and set up Staal in front. But the Jets break that up, and it's cleared by Bogosian all the way down the ice.
Great puck movement there. Letang, a little dish to Staal. Staal back to Letang, over to Niskanen with Cook in front.
Good looking power play for the Penguins, minus Malkin and Crosby and company.
Down to 5 seconds of this man advantage. Here's Niskanen with it. Going to go in front to Dupuy. Good read by Stewart. He broke it up. And Niskanen got hit on the near wall by Thorburn. The penalty's over. Hainsey on the ice. He goes to the bench. And good skating by Zbigniew Pikalik as he headmans the puck off the stick of Pascal Dupuy. Back to play at Bogosian. And Vitaly takes it away from him. Now Dupuy moves it to the right side. Adams a shot and a save made by Pavlik. And there's Vitaly right on top of the Jets goaltender looking for a rebound.
Well, let's take a look at some of the puck movement by the Penguins. Watch how they're just going to shift this puck around the ice. Letang moving it over to Jordan Staal. Jordan Staal is going to get a little bit of movement. He's going to go back the other way. I mean, great puck movement, and it just keeps moving along to Niskanen with Cook in front. Look at this. Pavlik can't even see at all. His vision impaired. This is the way you have to start hockey games. They started the second period this way, the Penguins. Shots now 11 to 10. Good stuff.
Our thanks to Range Resources for providing our telestration throughout the game tonight. Now taken by Vitali. He's got two feet with him. His shot stays. Rebound Hulse. Ripped away at the last second. Bufflin was there. Now to the near side. It'll be taken by Blake Wheeler. Great chance for the Penguins, and quick stick prevented the Penguins from getting a second opportunity.
Yeah, you're right. You're so right. Bufflin, you don't give him credit sometimes. You saw Letang in the first period do that. Bufflin here in the second period. We saw what Bufflin did on that second goal by the
Adams. Yeah. Shoots one through the goal mouth. Now it's Wheeler busting down the wing. Taken by Dupuis, and Dupuis moves it up the wing, off the stick of Adams.
Just over 15,000 this building holds, and it's pretty loud.
Now they're so hungry. They were so hungry for NHL hockey to return that, you know, they're going to be very boisterous for a long time. They waited a long time to get this opportunity to cheer for their team again. Now it's taken by Pavlik. Behind the net, Stewart. Sullivan steps in. And gloved out to the blue line where Englund moves it along for Letang. Wrist shot through traffic. That was blocked in front by Stewart. It gets up. Neal with it. Works it behind the net. Sullivan. Sullivan steps out. Sullivan in front now, Neal, and he can't get himself turned around to shoot it. Now he does. And it's blocked in front. Out to Letang, a drive. Pavlik made the save on that. Sullivan with a rebound, centers for Neal. Broken up by Stapleton. And he's able to find Brett McLean, who comes back. Ahead now for Shifley. He can go through, and the Penguins counterattack. Sullivan down the wing. Slap shot. Blocked by Stewart. That hurt him.
That's
and
two blocks.
Able to clear the center.
Oh, man.
Slater has great speed. He gets in on the puck. Englund punishes him. And Stahl follows on, but now it's Tanner Glass with it. Sends for Slater. Kicks it up to his stick. Looks for Thorburn, but instead goes for the point to Bogosian. Now to Slater. Chopped away from him by Chris Letang to center.
Boy, what a pace here. The Penguins are set in the second period. You wonder who in the dressing room steps up. Is it the coach? Is it a player? Did anything need to be said after that first period of play? But Penguins are totally different in this period.
Engler working hard to try to get possession here against Kyle Wellwood, who makes a nice pass to Entropop. Clear to save. Entropop with the rebound. And he pushed it wide of the goal. Aaron Asham able to lift it up to center ice. And after it is Chris Kunitz. Kunitz has Stahl going to the front of the net. Can't get him the puck. But Kyle Wellwood has played well in this game so far. He's on the ice at center as the puck's driven along to the net. Flurry the save. Martin to the rebound. And now Niskanen tries to play it, as does Letestis. For Bistrov, he was poked from behind by Kunitz just as he wanted to pull the trigger. Now it's Antropov with it. Out for Bistrov, and it doesn't connect. Asher couldn't get to it. Shot to the net by Bufflin. Was steered by Fleury to the near side. Now Martin hit hard on the near wall by Bermistrov. Hits Antropov with it. He tries to get it on the net, and he hit Jordan Stahl. And now Paul Martin has some time behind the net to move it out to Jordan Stahl. Up towards the net, Pavlik. He's going to scoop it up and hold on to it.
Great stuff here. Both ends of the rink. Players paying the price, blocking shots, taking hits to make plays.
Nothing Winnipeg here in the second period, and the Jets are still looking for a new mascot. How about Winnie the Pooh? True story here. A member of the Canadian Army donated a small bear to the London Zoo way back in 1918. Now, the original owner named him Winnie after his hometown of Winnipeg. Later, a man by the name of A.A. Milne began writing children's books about his son's toy animals, one of which was called Winnie the Pooh, guys. So I think you know where the story goes from there. So I guess it's a thought, maybe.
It is. It's better than the end of that name.
Here's Bogosian dumping it in. Look out. Oh, how about that bounce? And then Fleury accidentally stumbled and knocked the net off the moorings.
And look at the referees giving it to him. Oh, come on. What do you want him to do? He's just trying to get out of the way. That's keeping your eye on the puck right there. Could easily went in off the body of Marc-Andre Fleury and into the cage. That hard wraparound.
They need to repair the little rut in the paint there. Fleury's pointed out, and they need to fix that now.
Let's take a look. There's Fleury going behind the net to play it, and then it just hits him in the pants. Boy, he's lucky. Just actually at the side of the net. Didn't hit him in the pants. It might have went in. And the chance of Fleury. In the building.
Penguins are 36-16-1 against the Jets in their history, 13-9-1 in Winnipeg. And all those games were played in the old Winnipeg Arena. This is a new facility here that was built for the American League team. Aaron Ashton lifts it up inside the Winnipeg zone. Matt Cook is left with a test to it. Never got through. Bogosian able to move it up. And a nice pass by Antropov to Bermistrov. Those two have some pretty good chemistry together. McCauley tries to get it out of the zone. Held in by Bogosian. Fleury hailing the puck behind the net. Almost had his pocket picked by Wellwood. And Lovejoy tried to bank it ahead. Great stick by Bermistrov. Wellwood shot. Oh, he missed the net. Great chance off the glass. Bermistrov with it. Now McCauley picks the pocket of Antropov. And then Wellwood tries to return the favor. Ashton trying to get it out. I'll tell you, you really got to bear down tonight along the wall because that puck keeps changing possession. You think you got it, and you don't.
What about the combination here of Lovejoy and McCauley for a good portion of that shift from your own end?
Now it's Lovejoy and Letang, and this is Little. Good speed. Toby Enstrom wristing it from a sharp angle all the way through to the near side of Kunitz. Turns away from Little on a nice play. Out to Stahl. And it kind of wanders away from him, but he's able to maintain possession. Ladd steps in front of Stahl. Now a nice bit of forechecking by Chris Kunitz on Toby Enstrom, who tried to flush it up the boards with that long stick. Kunitz goes rink-wide, but paying a shot. The hit escape comes right back to Kunitz. Oh, he almost sneaked one in on the short side on Pavlik. Centering pass, Stahl! He shot him on a save, made it off the goalpost. And Pavlik reaches out and taps the post and thanks it for making another save here. Here's Blake Wheeler into the Penguins zone. Lost the puck at Dupuis, banked it off the boards, and here comes Chris Kunitz. Kunitz with Dupuis streaking into the play. And it's off the arm, I believe, of the goaltender Pavlik. And then back to Matt Niskanen at center ice. Good up and down action right now. Niskanen ahead for Dupuis, who steers it into the Winnipeg zone.
Well, Stahl deserved a better fate, as did Kunitz there in that shift for the Penguins. Off the goalpost to the blocker side of the goaltender Pavlik. With a lot of passion, the Penguins hop right now.
Sullivan moves it out to Paul Martin. Martin. Niskanen. His shot save. Clark there for the rebound. Right through the goal mouth, and the Penguins couldn't get a stick on it to finish it off. Now it's James Neal to Niskanen. Martin, a shot off a body.
Penguins.
And Pavlik's coming out of the net. He's heading to the box. He's got to go all the way across the red line. Slater actually got to that puck. The whistle blew, and the Jets want to know why it blew, because Slater got there and was able to pass it. The Penguins really never had even close to having possession on that, but the whistle blows, and Pittsburgh will be shorthanded.
Another good chance. Richard parked out by the goalpost, and Park almost put it in a vacated net behind Pavlik. Take a look here. The puck goes right behind Pavlik. He jams it through the 4x6, right through the crease. And I tell you, Pavlik's got horseshoes right now. He's got them going in this 2-0 game, and Penguins looking to break the shutout. Maybe a shorthanded tally. They've already got two of them. A problem in the penalty box as they ring the horn here, so we'll have a short delay.
First power play chance for Winnipeg in this game. Their power play has been anemic so far. 0-13, 0-7 in their only home game. Their opener against the Montreal Canadiens. And now they have a chance with a faceoff in the offensive zone to add to their lead.
Enstrom and Byfuglien, who played together last year for really the whole season. And Byfuglien, you mentioned the pace of his shot. He was second in the hardest shot competition to Zdeno Chara last year at the All-Star game.
Byfuglien is wearing skates that are manufactured by a company that is owned by Mario Lemieux, MLX Skates. He loves them. Says it's really improved his skating. Brad Stewart, Mark Stewart, I should say, also wearing them. Now it is Wellwood with it. Tim Thomas wears them as well. A lot of players are wearing them. This is Bermistrov with it now. You can go to the MLX website and look at those skates if you want. Google MLX Skates, Mario Lemieux's company. Here's Byfuglien shooting wide of the goal. Off the board. Blocked beautifully by Martin on the chance by Wellwood. And Adams gets to the puck. Penguins penalty killer comes to center and slides it up into the Winnipeg zone.
Two great plays. One by Adam to deny that pass to Byfuglien for a good portion of that power play. And then Martin with the slide play, saving maybe the third goal.
Penguins have been perfect in penalty killing on the road. They've killed all 11 against them. They're trying to do it again here and keep themselves within striking distance in this hockey game, down 2-0. Bermistrov has had a great game so far. Leaves it for Little. Ryan Little has as Antropov open in front. Goes to the point instead of Unstrom. Now to Bufflin. Slap pass. Dupuis read that. Broke it up. It was intended for Little. Gets to the puck and moves it out to the point to Enstrom. Enstrom. Bufflin. Slap shot. Save made by Fleury. And a ricochet right to the stick of Dupuis, who wheels it down the ice.
Letang with his hands full, and Antropov in front of the net. He's a big customer there. Fleury was able to get out high in the crease to knock down that Bufflin shot.
Now it's Wheeler, big guy. Shoots it, and a save by Fleury, and he holds on to it.
There's a lot of battle going on right now. Players looking for ice, good puck movement. Take a look at Adams. He's trying to deny the pass to Bufflin here. Look at it. He's a forward trying to deny that pass. He wants it to go down low behind the goal line so the Penguins can activate. Finally, it gets there. It finally does get. But look at his positioning. You wouldn't think that a forward would do that. But look at him. He's still in that lane. Taking it away. Taking it away. Look how much time. Finally, it's a dish pass that has to get through there. A tough pass to make.
They win the draw. Bogosian shot, Fleury the save, pushes the rebound to the corner. Hard work on the near wall by Derek Englund against Ladd, but they win the battle. It's Little, turns the corner, has the man open. Shot by Oduya, and he hammered it wide of the goal.
Say the puck just crossed the blue line here.
Oduya with a blast as the puck came from behind the net. Marc-Andre Fleury looking over his right shoulder. Stuck deep to that goal line. That puck had found its mark. 17 shots for Winnipeg, 15 for the Penguins. Only 1 second left in the park penalty, so he'll jump out. Bogosian will have to stand right by that penalty door.
There's Little with it. Centering it. It goes right through the paint to the far side. Taken now by Stewart. Neal. Sullivan's going to take the puck now for the Penguins. But they're still perfect on the road in the penalty killing department. They've got all 12 power plays against them on the road. Neal tries to go across to Sullivan. Ladd is there, lost his stick. Neal's got it, shoots it right in front. Pavlik finds the deflection.
Oh, boy, they called the penalty. They called a late penalty. Wasn't even close, Dagan. The Penguins bench is up in arms right now. What a bad call. Referee looked down 10 seconds late. Maybe not a bad call, but certainly a late one and a frustrating one.
Well, the officials really did not get a good look at this, but Neal is going to go to the box for breaking a stick. Neal didn't get the puck out here. It goes the other way. Well, Ladd's playing it. Neal just pushed him on the side of the hip, keeping two hands on the stick. The referee then looked and saw the broken stick. He's going to call Neal for a slash. That was a bad call, and you're allowed to say they made a mistake. The referee caught it out of the corner of his eye, didn't really see it properly. The Penguins are going to have to kill it.
And here's Zabinek Mikalik, and he lifts it all the way down the ice. Penguins with 10 shots here in the second period to 5 for the Jets. And they were able to get a big shot from Dustin Bufflin on that last power play. Not much else. Antropov leaning on Paul Martin. Now it's Matt Cook. He finds an angle to get it out and all the way down the ice. They're just joining us. The Jets scored 8 seconds in. Kyle Wellwood and then Tanner Glass got one late in the first period to make it 2-0. Here's Bogosian shooting. Save by Fleury. Rebound. Mikalik fires it down the ice.
You give Bogosian that shot any time. Nobody in front. Off a rush. You're not going to beat Marc-Andre Fleury from that kind of range and nobody in front of him. It's an easy out for the Penguins.
Mistrov. He's looked good. Wheeler shoots. Fleury finds the rebound. He was going to do something with it, but it was cleared away by Mikalik before he could pounce on it. And now Wheeler with it. Out to Toby Enstrom. Right back to Blake Wheeler. Former Phoenix Coyote and Boston Bruin. Now Dupuis has it go floating right by him and back into the Winnipeg zone. 39 seconds to go on the penalty to James Neal. Steal by Dupuis, and he's able to wrist it down the ice.
New power play goals for the Jets this season.
Jets had a couple goal lead on the Hawks in their second game and blew that. Ladd, big strong captain of the Jets, tried to center one and it's cleared by the Penguins. I really think that if the Penguins can stay within two here and kill this penalty, they've got a shot to get back into this game at any time.
How many times has the penalty killing unit of the Penguins really
catapulted them to victories and changed momentum.
Here's Bogosian with it, though. Bogosian, Bufflin, big slap shot coming up. He just kind of took a little off it, and it hit Craig Adams. Penalty's over. Neal's on the ice. And Adams, checked by Little. Ladd to the puck. One-timer Bogosian. He missed the cage to the corner. Little behind the net for Wheeler. Bumped by Adams. He knocked him down. Wheeler gets back up. Ladd helps out. Out to Bogosian. Now to the right point in Bufflin. Cross ice. Ladd has to corral the puck. Finds Bogosian. Right back to Bufflin. Wrist shot. That hit a skate of Paul Martin. It's picked up by Neal, and he lifts it out to the neutral zone. 5:32 to go in the second period. Shifley on the ice right now. The puck is cleared by Engel in the center, and it's driven right back in by Bogosian. Bogosian taken third overall in 08. Shifley taken seventh overall in 2011. Paul Martin leads it up to the corner for Joe Vitale. Vitale got there. Good job. And negate the icing call. But now the Jets end up with possession. Here comes Bogosian to center. Bogosian delays. Try to get it to the net. It hit Lovejoy and comes right to Chris Thorburn. And the former Penguin battles against Joe Vitale. Thorburn turns off the wall and goes to Bogosian. A shot flagged down easily by Lovejoy, who moves it along for Dupuis. And now for Joe Vitale. The stall. Bogosian hits Vitale. Stalls hit by Thorburn. Stall tried to work it in front. Bogosian was there. Cleared aside by Glass, but Vitale holds it in for Dupuis. To the corner now for Jordan Stall. Stall centers. And it comes back to the net. Kunitz thrashing around trying to get to it. Held in by Niskanen? No, he tried to kick it in, and Lovejoy gets it instead and drives it up into the Winnipeg zone. Around to the near side for Chris Kunitz. He's got some time. He's got a man open, Letang. And there goes the Niskanen shot. Save made by Pavlik, and he finds a rebound.
Well, he smothered that one up, but he kicked the other rebound out where he should have got his team a break. They were exhausted. Look at Bogosian. Can't even breathe.
Nothing Winnipeg. Don't forget to stay tuned for our Miller Lite Taste Greatness moment coming up.
Sounds good.
And there's got to be some great moments for the Penguins coming in this game. They still haven't been able to get the puck behind Andre Pavlik. Mark Letestu still looking for his first goal. It is 2-0 with 4:08 remaining in the second period. Here's a chance. Oh, Cook fanned on it. And Antropov works it out to center. Niska. Quick pass ahead to Letestu, who dumps it in. Now Pavlik works it in the corner, and Oduya sends it up the wall. He had a tough game. Oduya, an opening night, and was scratched in the second game. And he's a guy they're going to rely on. And Oduya's going to, he's got to play well for them to play well as a team, I think. An icing call here. McDonald's High School football continues to bring you the best in the area. Quad A state champion North Allegheny will play Shaler Friday at 7:30 on Root Sports. If you're at the game, make sure to catch the replay at midnight.
So the Penguins have to stay on the ice. Aaron Asham, Portage la Prairie. No more sunny days anywhere in Canada than there. Portage la Prairie, where they get a lot of floods, but a lot of sun as well. About 13,000 people. Population?
Dustin Bufflin. Leads it up the right wing. Park got a stick on it. Lovejoy back to play it. Stays with it nicely after the bump by Stapleton. And now the Penguins get it going north. Here's a chance. Richard Park down the wing. Sullivan to Park. The shot. Great save by Pavlik on Richard Park. Great passing play by Sullivan and Park. And Pavlik somehow is ready to make that last save.
He threw his glove up there. Just flashed the leather. Got a piece of rubber on that. Great save and a great play. All the way from James Neal in his own zone.
Here comes Park again. Sullivan, shy, missed the goal, and it comes off the corner boards, and it'll be picked up in flight by Brett McLean. He's got Wheeler with him. McLean cuts to the net. He's the goal scorer, but Wheeler has to play. It's delayed a plan. A good chance for Shifley, and Fleury makes a great save on Mark Shifley. The great saves at both ends of the rink. Now it's Wheeler again with it. Ladd goes to the net. Wheeler trying to drop it off to Little. Stahl had a stick on it. Sullivan's got to be tired. He's been up and down the ice a couple of times. He goes to the bench. Kunitz replaces him. Over to play it now with Wheeler. He cuts in front of Paul Martin. Kunitz tries to get possession. Wheeler, he's been out here a while too. Now it's Stahl, and he works it out for Dupuis off his stick. And going back forward into his own zone is Toby Anderson. Dupuis hot on his trail. Kunitz couldn't play it on the near boards, and it comes out to center. 2:09 to go in the second period. Great pace to this game. Here's Kunitz with it. He's got Dupuis open to the wall. Here he is. A shot. Another great save on Pascal Dupuis. Couldn't lift it as he went to the backhand.
Same play, same save. Exactly. He went down on that new crest and he put the glove up and denied Pascal Dupuis this time.
Dupuis again out to Letang. Letang, England, a shot. Good save again by Andre Pavlik, and on their feet here in Winnipeg.
And they should be. Clean save by Pavlik, all with the glove hand. Take a look at James Neal. A hard, crisp pass between two defenders. Watch this give and go. Hart, Sullivan, Hart, watch the glove right there. He actually extends the glove out to meet the puck on its way up. Then Kunitz to Dupuis. Same play, same glove. He gets the glove more towards the puck. He doesn't put the glove back. He puts it down as if he's trying to trap that puck on its way up.
Another shot, scores! A beating McCulloch off the faceoff. Drills one in on the stick side this time of the goaltender, and the Penguins make it 2-1. And there's your even strength goal from a defenseman you've been calling for, Bob.
I
as
have.
McCulloch fired it from the point.
The Penguins, Matt Cook jumps off that faceoff. Look at the traffic in front. Pavlik tried to get out there and cut the angle down. And after three tremendous glove saves, the blast by McCulloch off the blocker. Fans don't like the fact that Matt Cook toppled over the goaltender, but it was after the puck was in the net. It's 2-1. McCulloch, and you've got to feel good for McCulloch, who was a -7 at that point prior to that faceoff.
It's now 2-1, and that's the big goal we were talking about that gives the Penguins something to show for all the work they've done. They've been phenomenal here in the last half of the second period, and nothing to show for it until McCulloch finally blasted one in past Andre Pavlik. Best we've ever seen him play against the Penguins. Here's Thorburn, left side, look out, shot Slater, save made by Fleury on the rebound, dropped that by Tanner Glass, and Fleury stopped that. Now it's Asham ahead to Matt Cook. Matt Cook to Aaron Asham, back to Cook, great passing. Cook will attest to, he reaches back for it, Asham's open, wants the puck. Letestu against Glass, he threw his shoulder into Letestu. Now Cook trying to get to it. Letang does a good job to keep it in, back towards the net. Tipped wide of the goal by Letestu and picked up and moved by Bufflin out the center. Glass takes it. 45 seconds to go in the second period.
Comeback period of sorts for the Penguins here in the second.
Neal trying to get to the puck. The Penguins have been phenomenal, really. When you think about the opportunities they've had, they've been really, it could have had 5 or 6 goals in this game. Tyler Kennedy said something after the Buffalo game. He said, we've got to get better at finishing. Here's Antropov with it now. And sometimes you just have to give credit to the goaltenders. We got a penalty coming up here, a hooking call.
They're coming against, looks like the Penguins. Yeah, the Penguins.
Oh, yeah, hooked Antropov right at the side of the net.
Here's the faceoff here. Take a look. Matt Cook jumps on it after the Slater wins the draw. And then there's Matt Cook coming across. There's no room there, really. And watch Pavlik. This is what they're upset about. Does he get bumped right there, right before the goal gets in? Maybe. You know, I could see you on the flip side. I could see your argument, but it doesn't matter now. It's 2-1. McCulloch found that blocker side. It was a great feed by Letang and a great play by Matt Cook all the way around.
Ladd driving towards the net. Out to Enstrom. Penguins killed two penalties so far, trying to kill a third before the end of the period. This will carry over to the third period. 2 seconds ago, Ladd with a shot, blocked by McCulloch, and there's the horn ending a wild second period of play. Penguins with 15 shots in that second period, 11 for the Winnipeg Jets. And the puck was moving up and down the ice in a hurry in that second period. Fort Pitt Capital by the numbers, second period recap.
Look at Pavlik's going over the referee right now. As you look at the shots, 22-21, chances now in favor of the Pittsburgh Penguins in that second period. 9-3, the chances, incredible. And I don't know who you give that faceoff win to. Slater won it, but Cook got possession of it. Great play by the Penguins.
2-1. They got a good shot at this.
Dan Potash will visit with Chris Thorburn, who fought Derek Engelin, the former Penguin. Rob King with highlights from around the NHL. And highlights of this excellent hockey game coming up. The Penguins trail by 1-2 to the Winnipeg Jets. Very entertaining hockey game so far. Tough start for the Penguins, but they've really come on and made it a very interesting game. 2-1 Winnipeg through two. Let's take a look at what you've missed. Hustles in against the Tang, takes the puck away from him. Great play. Shot by Glass. He scores. Banner Glass on a great play by Vermistrov. Here's Kunitz with it. He's got Dupuy on it. To the wall. Here he is. A shot. Hamlet makes another great save. Another shot. Scores! A beating McCulloch off the faceoff. Drills one in on the stick side this time of the goaltender. And the Penguins make it 2-1. Let's go down outside the Penguins locker room to Dan Potash.
All right, guys, thank you. It's time for our UPMC Sports Medicine interview with assistant coach Todd Reardon. And you started to see a little bit more momentum in your favor in that second period. What were you doing differently? How do you carry it over to the third?
Certainly our battle and compete was at a whole different level than it was in the first period. So we were able to generate some offense and get a faceoff goal there. But more importantly was how we hunted and battled for pucks. I think that made a huge difference for us that period.
Maybe a couple holes in that goaltender too, huh?
Definitely. We've got to keep getting chances. We've got to keep on them and hopefully find a tying goal here in the next few minutes.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Dan.
Staggy, Bobby.
Thanks, Danny. Well, yeah. A lot of passion, a lot of grunt work. And Matt Cook, you got to put him right in the middle of that. Maybe in the front of that, because he was involved in the goal, not only making the pass, but getting to the front in front of the goaltender, bumping him. He's also a big part of the Penguins' penalty killing. And their penalty killing actually dropped off at the end of last season without Matt Cook. Still, they were number one. But Matt Cook and the Penguins' penalty killing going to have to propel them in this third period.
McCulloch getting his first, and that was a good shot that he took, too. He was a true shot on the net. And we talked about with Dan Bilesma the other day about all the zone time the Penguins get, and how do you translate that to goals, and that's a good example of it. And you get the guy at the point with the shot, you go to the net hard with traffic, and real traffic, where you really disrupt the concentration of the goaltender to get the goal. Fine line between goalie interference and not on that play, but the Penguins got away with it, got the goal, and now they're down to within one. But they've got some more penalty killing to do with Steve Sullivan in the box for a minute 45.
And they don't score their goal if McCulloch's not on the left point. He's typically a right defenseman, but he was playing the left point on that faceoff. He was able to one-time a pass from Chris Letang. And interesting, it was McCulloch playing the left, not Chris Letang. So it was McCulloch they actually set up for the shot on that faceoff. Don't know if it was designed or not, but McCulloch was the trigger man.
And he put it right where he had to. Here's Ladd trying to split the D. Good diving play by McCulloch to knock it away from him at the last second. Now it's Bufflin with it for Ladd behind the net.
If you protect the puck with your skate there, Ladd, if you get your left foot out like Crosby would do or Malkin, you get a trip there. You might get a penalty shot. McCulloch was beat by the speed of Ladd. The stick came in. But if you protect the puck with your skate, you're going to get a penalty call or maybe a penalty shot.
Now Dupuy able to bank it off the boards and back up into the Winnipeg zone. Back to get it goes Toby Enstrom. Stahl working hard. Dupuy follows on. Shorthanded. 52 seconds to go on the penalty. Toby Enstrom trying to get on track. He and Antropov and Vermistrov on the ice, along with Kyle Wellwood and Dustin Bufflin and Toby Enstrom. Now it's Bogosian on the ice at the right point. And the Penguins try to clear, and they do get it past Enstrom. And it goes the length of the ice. 30 seconds to go on the penalty to Steve Sullivan.
Bogosian, you talked about him a lot in the second period. Mentioned his name moving up on the play. 24 career goals for that blue line.
Vermistrov whistles one wide off the glass, and it comes all the way back to neutral ice. Matt Cook chasing Vermistrov. 9 seconds to go on this power play. Vermistrov, slick little player. Out to the point, Bufflin. Bogosian a drive, Fleury to save. He wasn't quite sure where the puck was, but it's frozen in his equipment. And Sullivan comes out of the box. So the Penguins remain perfect on the road in penalty killing. They've killed all 14 and all three here tonight. Let's take a look at tonight's energy. I want to do that later. First of all, our Facebook message to you. Make sure you like us on Facebook, and you can stay connected with all your local teams and other passionate fans like yourself. Show us how you root on Facebook, and let's go Pens.
Good save by Marc-Andre Fleury and Zach Bogosian, a hard one-timer, and that sort of McCulloch leg, if you will.
Tanner Glass, wraparound attempt, came right through the goal mouth, and now sent back up into the Winnipeg zone, taken by Bogosian. Look at him skate. Sullivan on his trail. Bogosian flying out of the defensive zone to center. Flying into the offensive zone, shoots it off the goal post.
You know, I was thinking for Bobby Orr, and he almost, almost put the exclamation point on that end-to-end rush. That was a thing of beauty. Is he chugging along?
That's the most dynamic rush we've ever seen from Zach Bogosian. Stahl, Dupuis, slap shot, save. Stahl goes to the net, runs over the goaltender.
They don't call anything because Stahl was pushed in by Johnny Oduya, but he just took a little shove, and then he said, hey, you're going to give me a little shove? I'm going to jump on the goaltender. Zach Bogosian used the net to protect himself. Streaming through the zone, and then that one-time shot. The goalpost, that snap, just pull it back in flight.
When he turned the corner, Richard Park was there, and Park kind of circled. You know, it would have been a ferocious collision if Park would have decided to line him up there, but he did not. He circled through and allowed him to get by him, and that just gave him more momentum and speed for the neutral zone.
And he had so much speed that he had to back up the Penguins defense for fear of them getting beat, and then they could shoot the puck and use them as a screen, and that was an inch away from going in.
That would have been a highlight reel goal if he'd have put it in.
He would have. I hope you're ready.
But it wasn't. And it's still 2-1. Oh, a big hit by Kunitz on Slater. Glass has the puck. Thorburn goes to the front of the net. Glass reverses it back for Thorburn. Martin gets position on him, but there's Slater. And rolled off his stick, and Dupuis shoves it out of danger. Glass with it again. It comes right back to Pascal Dupuis and over to Zabinek McCulloch. Now there's Stahl, who just touched it up into the Winnipeg zone. Oduya back to get it. Another big hit. Boy, Dupuis is a physical player this year for the Penguins. He makes people pay the price when he gets in there now. I think there was a feeling that earlier in Dupuis' career, he was a guy who would circle away in the situations like that. But Dan Bylsma, with his system in place, has kind of made it so that everybody has to go on a straight line to finish guys off, as Dupuis has been doing with regularity. And it's made him a better player. He's a very effective player, combining speed with grit, smarts, and desire.
And the war with another contract offseason.
And he loves Pittsburgh, Pascal Dupuis. Here's Derek Engelin with it. Moves it out past Aaron Asham. Pavlik out of the net. Sends it around to the near side for Aaron Asham. Trying to clog it up on the near wall, but they come to center. Antropov hit Cook with it. Wellwood to Vermistrov. Vermistrov shoots it. Good save made. And a good one by Marc-Andre Fleury.
And the fans are clapping for Marc-Andre Fleury, I believe. A beautiful save in amazement. And down at that one end, the gloves of both goaltenders in the second. And now in the third by Marc-Andre Fleury as he snatches that one out of midair. Vermistrov has been very visible in the hockey game. A pair of assists.
Park against Little has done a good job on the draws tonight, Ryan Little. Here's Bogosian.
Ryan Little, 8-2, 80% in the faceoff.
Look out! Look out, chance for Sullivan. Put it in a shot. Great save again by Pavlik. You believe this? Boy, I'll tell you, when you have players going from left to right in front of him, he is good at getting over and making saves as he robs one on a chance by Steve Sullivan.
He's good at moving right to left to his glove hand, and then he kind of goes out towards the shooter. Down, out, and he kind of tries to meet that puck as it's rising. Tries to trap it on its way up. Once again, he did the same thing. Puts the glove right on top of his pad. Now that time, Sullivan hit the pad. In the second period, two players hit the glove. Let's go blocker side on him.
Lovejoy, Niskanen, he whistled that one up off the glass. Stays in play, the Penguins have it. Park behind the net on his backhand. Now for Neil to Lovejoy, and his shot blocked by Ladd. And Niskanen over to play it. Matt Niskanen banks it ahead. James Neal tried to touch it along for Park, couldn't do that. And Wheeler into the Penguin zone. Has Ladd alongside. And Little. Now it's Ladd taking it. Shot hit Little. And Lovejoy on his backhand, able to get it up the wall. And it comes bouncing over to the Winnipeg zone as the Penguins are able to change. The Jets will also make a change up front. The tally comes on along with McIntyre. Wellwood trying to go to Antropov. The pass was in the air. It's knocked out of midair by Paul Martin. Steve McIntyre out here. And a rare shift. Let's put him in the lineup today when Connor Kennedy couldn't go. Here's Antropov shooting. And a save made by Fleury on Nick Antropov. Our Energy Alliance player of the game. And yes, Matt Cook, you talked about him earlier.
Well, he's pumped up and ready to go. We're out west here. Matt Cook played for the Vancouver Canucks. Not against the Winnipeg Jets.
Oduya with a wrister to the corner. Back through the goal mouth area to the near side. Dupuy just whacks it back off the boards. Didn't get it out. Eric England's got to go back for it one more time with Tanner Glass on him. Stahl gave it away to Thorburn. Man open as Toby Enstrom couldn't get it through because Chris Kunitz read the play and picked it off. He comes back, leads it up the wing for Dupuy. He shoots it. He had to get rid of it quickly. And it's off the stick of Enstrom up into the netting. And now a confrontation between Toby Enstrom and Chris Kunitz after the whistle. We'll return to Winnipeg in a moment. Still 2-1 Jets. Time for our Miller Lite Taste Greatness moment.
Well, it's got to be the blast by Zbigniew McCulloch to cut the lead in half for the Penguins. And McCulloch, first of the season. Penguins have 8 shots of 21 going into this third period of play. So they're starting to get some action using those point men.
In his own zone, under pressure from Stahl and Kunitz, sends it up the wall. Slater down the boards to try to get to it. And they do, work it out to center ice, and Chris Thorburn, inside-outside move, tries to split to the D, and he is flattened by Chris Letang. It shows you that great leverage there as he just knocked him right down. He's a big man, too, Thorburn. Now it's Kunitz. Kunitz looks to the right wing. Letang has a little look. He shoots it in the save made by Pavlik. And then Thorburn bumps Letang after he shot the puck. Let's take a look at our Subway sandwich of the game.
Now this is appropriate here as he tries to go between Englund and Letang. Letang closes that gap very quickly. Tosses Thorburn down to the ice. Our Subway sandwich of the game.
Now everybody changing up here as there'll be a face-off to the left of Pavlik. There's Chris Thorburn, the former Penguin, a former Buffalo Sabre.
Got in the fight with Derek Englund here if you just joined us.
Great guy, by the way. Shot wide of the goal by Lovejoy. Really one of the likable people who's ever come through Pittsburgh. And every time we see him, it's like it's old home week for Chris Thorburn. He wasn't in Pittsburgh a long time, but you can tell that he has good memories and really appreciates the relationships he developed in Pittsburgh. Up ahead it comes now to Wheeler, and he'll slip it in behind Niskanen. Lovejoy over to play it. Back for Niskanen. He's bumped. Letestu follows on to help out. Finds Lovejoy, and away he goes. Hands it off to Aaron Asham. He'll dump it up into the Winnipeg zone. Matt Cook in after it around Bogosian. Cook trying to play that puck on the wall. Gets it to Letestu. Nice play. Letestu goes to the point to Matt Niskanen. Niskanen, wrist shot.
Oh, it hits
traffic.
Ahead. Oh,
it hit a man right in the head. It hit Stewart. The shot took off and hit him up high. And Stewart getting himself up very quickly here.
I just can't believe I don't see blood right now. I mean, he got hit right in the head with that shot. He's not wearing a visor, and he's running right into the dressing room. And I don't see any blood on the ice. I can't believe it. Did it hit him in the helmet? Stewart in front of the net.
Got his hands a little bit up in front of his face. Turns and just hits him just on the edge of that helmet. He is so fortunate. He is so fortunate. A rising wrist shot.
He saw it coming and turned his head. Fortunately, it did not strike him in the face, right off the top of his helmet. And now here's McCullough's shot. Save, rebound. Neal tried to corral it, just couldn't do it. Now Cook, the Neal is shot. Park set him up. Sullivan with a chance, and that's blocked. And Buffalo able to wrap it around the boards and all the way down the ice. And back to get it goes McCulloch. And a nice shin call against Winnipeg.
And the Penguins have already got the one faceoff goal by McCulloch. McCulloch, another great opportunity here on the faceoff. And now a third faceoff crack from the same spot. Let's take a look. There's McCulloch. Remember in the first period, it went from D to D. This one goes directly to McCulloch. And that puck skips on the way in to Pavlik. And Neal going right to the net.
Park taking the draw against Burmistrov. Park wins the draw. Neal had a piece of it, but then couldn't play it. Buffalo sends it behind, and a good hustle by Richard Park to get in there and try to get possession. Finally, the Jets, Buffalo moves it along for Antropov, who banks it off the boards. And good work by Sullivan to get back into the neutral zone and take that puck quickly. Over to Paul Martin, he uses the wall to try to get it ahead to Richard Park. Buffalo got in the way of that. Now Wellwood drops it back on defense. Johnny Oduya spins away from Steve Sullivan, ahead to Wellwood, who banks it off the wall and goes to the bench. Paul Martin goes back for the puck into his own zone. 2-1 Winnipeg, 11:23 to go in the third period. And listen to the crowd here, loving every minute of it. Here's Letang's shot, saved by Pavlik, rebound. Kunitz got to the puck but couldn't shoot it.
Vitaly deflected that shot on the way in by Chris Letang, big save.
This is Slater swinging wide. Slater's backhand pass goes behind the goal. Gets it back, it goes to the point to Toby Enstrom. Back in behind the net to Glass. Good work by Letang to get a stick on it first. Kunitz to Letang. And it comes right back to Thorburn. In deep now for Slater. Letang throws a shoulder into him and Joe Vitale. Ahead to Craig Adams at center. He'll send it down the wall and Bogosian just works it right back into the Penguin zone. The Jets are changing as Letang takes control of it for Pittsburgh. Englund with a long lead pass to Jordan Staal. Knocked away from him nicely by Bogosian. Picked up in flight by Brian Little. Little to Ladd. Ladd is great save by Fleury. And Wheeler was cutting through the goal mound, but he couldn't get a stick on it. And Marc-Andre Fleury was able to grab that puck and prevent any further play. And he holds on with 10:21 to go in the third.
Yeah, interesting. I mean, Wheeler did get a little stick on it, but it was a pass. Not enough pace on that to really get a good deflection. Wheeler driving the net, a quick 3-on-2 off the neutral zone. And a big save there in front by Marc-Andre Fleury. And again, he's got to shut the door right now.
Matt Cook picks it up. Penguins only down by one. This is Dupuis. Has a look. Shoots it. Pavlik out, took out the angle and made the save. Now it's taken by Staal. Dupuis. Center. Off the stick of Pavlik. And it comes right to Ladd. Ladd moves it ahead to Blake Wheeler. Just lifted inside the Penguin line. Taken there by Jordan Staal. Ben Lovejoy sends it up the boards. Into the Winnipeg zone, and Toby Enstrom goes back to play it. And it's an icing call against the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Well, we haven't seen anybody fall down after the first couple of shifts from McCulloch and Letang went down. The ice looks fast right now. It's up and down play. These teams are absolutely flying here in the last two periods of play. Pascal Dupuis, is there anybody faster?
Face-off to the right of Marc-Andre Fleury between Staal and Antropov, two big guys.
Nice face-off by Staal using the skate.
He's been really good on the draws in recent games. Clicking it. 25-15. And even better in the D zone. He was coming into this game 8-5 or late 3 in his last 11 face-offs in the defensive zone. And he won that one cleanly. Good to see Staal winning draws. That's such a big part of that role that he plays.
Now, he didn't do well in Edmonton, but he was slashed in Calgary, and Tyler Kennedy took a lot of the draws in Edmonton for Jordan Staal.
As his hand was hurting him a little bit. Now it's Joe Vitale. Vitale making a tough play to get it out, and he does work it back to center ice. Vitale able to dump it inside the line no further. Bogosian snaps it up into the Penguin zone. No ice. No icing on the play. Thorburn hits Bacala. Now Paul Martin up the boards for Vitale. And Joe Vitale goes to the right wing to Aaron Asher. Asher steps in. Nice play. Oh, he wanted to drag it in and then shoot it. And Bogosian got over to sweep it off the stick. Here's Paul Martin with it. His shot wide. In deep. The Testu had a stick on it. Now Thorburn. And he's able to flip it back to center. Racing to the puck is Tanner Glass. Little tang right there. Loses an edge. Gets back up quickly. Gets to the puck. Sends it up the right wing. Off the skate of Vitale, who's got to go to the bench. Richard Park, the first man on the puck. Neal in there with him. Bufflin able to stick handle on a phone booth and work it to the far side, but Sullivan races over to get it. Now it's cleared by Little, and it's going to go the length of the ice. This will be an icing call. England getting there first. And another faceoff coming up in the Winnipeg zone.
Richard Park warned by the referee. I saw that little sneaky trip, he said. But they let it go with 8:11 left on the clock. The shots are even. The score isn't. The Penguins need to find one here with an 8:11 left on the clock. Maybe another faceoff goal.
Faceoff to the right. Park to take it.
Timeout because Bufflin's been on the ice for an extended period of time. As has Wheeler. Faceoff and a timeout by the Winnipeg Jets.
Don't forget, you can catch all the highlights from this game, and there are a lot of them. It will be condensed down into 30 minutes on Penguins Rewind tomorrow at 6:30 on Root Sports. And, of course, we will have another game for you tomorrow night as well, as the Penguins will meet the Minnesota Wild.
So this faceoff to the right of Pavlik. We got the wave going in Winnipeg. The wind is a-blowing, very strong. Dustin Bufflin.
The wind blows so strong here and it gets so cold. Randy Gillen, the former Penguin, said he lived here. He said, he still does, by the way, said you got to walk backwards to school. That's how he used to walk to school. He used to walk backwards so the wind wouldn't be hitting him right in the face. Neal centers one, Dustin Bufflin there. They move it out ahead now to Andrew Ladd. Ladd down the wing, shoots it, good save, rebound, shot, great save by Florian Ladd. Another chance, Fleury got a piece of that into the puck, batted out of the air by the tag. Bufflin got in there and got a second crack at it, or was it a third crack? Now it's Wheeler with it. Wheeler trying to barge in, Fleury freezes the puck and stops the music, and we have seen some sensational show-stopping goaltending at both ends of the rink here tonight.
And Chris Letang, not a bad goaltender either.
Kid, Aaron Asham, closing in on 700 NHL games, believe it or not, tonight his first professional game in his home province of Manitoba. Looking for 2 points, guys.
Yep, the Penguins are looking for a goal. They're down by one. Fleury keeping them in the hunt with a couple of great saves a moment ago. Sullivan trying to get it out. Wheeler wouldn't let him do that. Bufflin back to the net. Stick save made by Fleury. And it's McCulloch with it. Neal. Letestu. A stutter step move on Bufflin. Good play. Centers up. Sullivan just pushed it wide. Now in deep for Letestu. Enstrom leaning on him. Good play for Sullivan behind the net. Neal goes to the front of the cage. Sullivan to the point. Chris Letang. Letang shoots, blocked by Wheeler. And Letang buried Vermeestrov into the boards on the near side. It's going to be a penalty. Vermeestrov getting up slowly. The Jets come after Letang here. And that was a heavy check, and he could really...
Well, Vermeestrov lost his footing there. He knew Letang was coming. It looked worse than it really was. Look at Letang after he makes the play. Watch Fleury tap Letang on the head and say, thank you. Thanks, buddy. And now Letang taps Vermeestrov on the seat of Vermeestrov's turns.
Yep.
Now Letang's going to hit him, and he's already engaged in his hit. He's already engaged, and Vermeestrov turns at the last second as Letang watches this. Vermeestrov puts himself in that position. You can't do that as a player. And there won't be any further call or decision, I believe, made anywhere other than what was made on the ice, a 2-minute penalty. Vermeestrov turns at the as he is engaged by Chris Letang.
Warning penalty to Chris Letang, and a great chance for the Thrashers to kind of put themselves in a position to get their first win of the year. They didn't score on the power play. They've been unable to score on three previous chances of this game. And now the puck off the stick of Burmistrov. It goes ricocheting up into the seats on the far side.
As a matter of fact, I thought Chris let up at the end there. I mean, players have to be accountable as well in those kind of situations when you're in a predicament.
Face off at center ice here, right on top of the jet.
In the center of that emblem.
And off the draw, Stahl back to Paul Martin. And he dumps it up. And we have Dupuis and Stahl up front on the PK for the Penguins with McCulloch and Martin back. Wheeler, Ladd, Little, Enstrom, and Bufflin on the power play. For Winnipeg, Buckland's shot, he tried to wrist it, gets it back, shoots it again, over the shoulder of Fleury to the near side. Blake Wheeler takes it there. Out for Enstrom, pass to Buckland, put him in trouble, and he's able to maintain possession. Throws it to open space on the near side where Enstrom will swing it back to Buckland. They're going the wrong way now on this power play.
Enstrom didn't see Stahl, who broke his stick on the Buckland shot, went to the bench, came back, Enstrom passed it as Stahl was coming back from the bench with the new switch.
Little goes down on the hit by Paul Martin, and Zabinek McCulloch finds Matt Cook at center. Matt Cook will push it ahead now for Adams. Enstrom protects the puck away from him over to Andrew Ladd. And now Pavlik has to play the puck back to Ladd. He cuts inside on Matt Cook, finds Bogosian to the left side, and Wheeler back to Bogosian. Bogosian's shot blocked. Niskanen cleared it, and then it was sent out of there by the Penguins to center ice. Now picked up by Wheeler. Now the 29 seconds to go on the penalty to Letang.
Yeah, that penalty killing trying to give him a chance again, isn't it?
Fleury can't stop it behind the net. Over to the far wall, Niskanen battling. So is Englund. Now it's Antropov with it. He's dangerous. That long reach. He goes to the point. Oduya right back for Antropov. Behind the net now to Wellwood. Al Wellwood. For Mistrov, lost the puck. Parks got it. 5 seconds to go on the penalty. Wellwood. Antropov. Shot. Save Fleury. And the rebound cleared, and here comes Letang into the box. Foot race, Letang to the puck, cut off by Bogosian, who's then able to clear it up the near wall. Now sent back in by Dupuis into the Winnipeg zone. 4:38 to go, the Penguins down by one, looking to tie this game up. They have had four perfect penalty killing efforts here tonight. Here's Kunitz, shooting, save made, rebound, Stahl looking for it. And it's cleared out the center by Thorburn. Back forward is Lovejoy with Thorburn bearing down on him. And he goes to his partner, Zabinek McCulloch, and up the boards down for Pascal Dupuis. Over for support is Chris Kunitz. Kunitz makes a beeline to the puck. Trying to get it in front. He's hit on the near side. Trying to kick it free. Stahl falls on. Now Kunitz is hooked by Thorburn. That's going to be a penalty. Penguins are going to get a power play. Kunitz centers. Stahl there. Pavlik snatches it out of midair.
Kunitz just got a stick up into the face, and he got caught for it, and it wasn't a smart play. Tanner Glass got a cross check in the face. Now we got Slater, who's hit one of the Penguins pretty hard here. The Lovejoy?
He just jumped him.
Yeah, he did.
And Lovejoy gets back up, and now he's not going to be able to throw any punches in return as they separate the two of them. Meanwhile, Kunitz and Glass having words after Kunitz had high stick Glass following what would have been a power play situation for the Penguins on a hook by Chris Thorburn. We'll see what happens, because maybe Slater ends up...
I don't know how it's all going to shake out. When we come back here, we'll get it sorted out for you. We'll see if anybody gets a power play. Well, Kunitz was knocked down by Thorburn in the corner. The hook, he felt it, he went down. The play continued, then there was a whistle. After that hit by Glass on Kunitz, Kunitz comes up high, just a shove with the glove. The hands were high, Glass certainly embellishing that. And then the other side of the ice, Slater and Lovejoy get tangled up. And that was the aftermath. And we'll see what happens and what comes out of it. Winnipeg are going to have to kill a penalty.
Glass is pointing to his nose saying it's bleeding. Oh, it should be a 5-minute penalty.
Looked like it was more of a glove. The hands were up. Two hands on the stick by Kunitz, but the glove hit him in the nose, it looked like. They call a two there, the initial two. and they can decide which penalty they want to put on the board. They put the Thorburn one on the board. He'll be coming out of the box. Penguins with an opportunity to tie it up.
Kunitz is in the box. Here's Martin shooting, and the Penguins on a power play with a chance to tie it up. For special teams, once again, in a position here to make the difference. Goaltending and special teams. Fleury outstanding here in the third period. The penalty killing, doing the job, and now a chance for the power play. Paul Martin will carry the puck. Out here with Staal and Sullivan and James Neal. Neal with the puck. Pushes it around to the right side for Sullivan. Well, Tang and Martin at the points. And it is Antropov for Winnipeg, and he'll shoot it down the ice. And the fans trying to get their penalty-killing unit going here to help the Jets get their first win. Their reincarnation here in Winnipeg. Here's Neal shooting, and it's off a stick. Close right to the glove of the goaltender. Let's take a look at our Stay on Your Feet play of the game brought to you by Timberland Pro.
And that's a big save on Burmistroff by Marc-Andre Fleury after Pavlik had just made a couple of beautiful glove saves of his own. And Marc-Andre Fleury has held the fort here. 32 Jet shots.
Goes out of play, and they're going to have to redrop it here to the right of Pavlik with 1:05 left in this penalty. Marc-Andre Fleury got a little help from his goalpost this period, a little help from Letang this period, and there's Pavlik at the other end, who's never beat the Penguins.
Oh, he missed a clear.
Niskanen, Letang. Letang, cross ice for Cook. And he's got to go get it. Back around for Dupuis, Letang there as well. Letang tries to pass it to Dupuis. Battle on the wall, Letestu there. Ladd working hard, as is Bogosian, who gets the puck over to Johnny Oduya, and he shoots it. Niskanen wouldn't let it go all the way down the ice. He got a piece of it, and Dupuis will go back and get it.
And now with the game on the line, they love to Oduya, who wasn't in the lineup.
This is Dupuis with speed against Bogosian. Shoots it off the end boards and around to the right side. It's going to come right to the Jets. Burmistrov couldn't get it out. Letang's shot was blocked. Now there goes Burmistrov. He's got speed. He's got a breakaway. In on goal. Saved by Fleury with a left pad on Burmistrov. Penguins are still alive. 13 seconds to go on the power play. Dupuis makes the shot. Lost his balance. Finds McCulloch, a shot out off the goal. Now it comes out to Cook. Cook looks at the net. His shot off the leg of Dupuis.
A stick at the box. Remember that save.
Penalty's over. Thorburn's on the ice.
And that was just enough pressure from Letang on the backside of Burmistrov. And Marc-Andre Fleury with a beautiful toe save. Pads post to post.
Neal tried one of his sneaky shots on the boards. It was blocked. A minute 35 to go. This is Wheeler. Martin backing in. Wheeler shoots it. Save made by Fleury. Man, the fans here are making all kind of noise. It is so loud. They're responding to everything. It's like it's a playoff game. They're so excited to have hockey back in Winnipeg. Centering pass.
And now here come the Penguins.
Sullivan over skates, but Neal follows on. Back to Sullivan. Back for Neal. He didn't know it was coming. But he's got it now. His shot. Pavlik will save.
A high, heavy shot by Neal. Pavlik with a left shoulder save. Final minute. No goalie. 6-on-5.
Fleury's on the bench. Letang on the ice. Shoots it in.
Penguins are short of player, aren't they? I missed something.
Now they're not.
Now they jump along.
Dupuis sneaking. He's sneaking in. And nobody's got him covered. And Cook over skates. Letang tries to get to the puck. It's up for grabs near side. Dupuis and Ladd converge on it. And it squirts out the center. Staal to Martin. Paul Martin. Fans on their feet. Dupuis centers. They have it. Empty net down to her left. Ladd just pushes it up into the Penguin zone. Back to get it goes Paul Martin. 24 seconds to go. Listen to this crowd here in Winnipeg. Unbelievable. As loud a crowd as we've ever heard. James Neal. Dupuis out of the reach of Neal. 12 seconds to go. Martin pushes it ahead for the empty net. And the shot misses on it. And Little, 5 seconds to go. Burmistrov with it to the empty net. Wheeler stopped in front by Dupuis, and time expires. And the Winnipeg Jets find a way to get their first win of the season against the Penguins as they hold on for a 2-1 win here tonight.
Now,
for at least 10 seconds, the Penguins had the netminder pulled but did not have the extra attacker on the ice. Now McDonald's player of the game, Andrei Pavlik, was able to hold the fort. He allowed one off the faceoff, and this place is going nuts.
I'm telling you, this is as loud a building as I've ever heard in the NHL. It's unbelievable. The Jets thought they would have a little bit of atmosphere here in Winnipeg than they had in Atlanta. I think so.
96
postgame decibels. Coming up wild tomorrow night. Don't forget. Stay tuned for the postgame show.